Hello everyone, I am Amir. Today we are going to start about our third chapter, that is genetics. Here we are going to discuss some basic things about genetics, that is definition, some terms related to genetics, Mendel and his experimental material, monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross, pedigree chart, sex-linked inheritance, mutation. So first we'll study about the definition. Before entering into genetics, why we are studying it? Sometimes you may have heard about the comment that you are looking like your mother or father or your brother and sister. So what are these? They are comparing your characters, and these characters are transmitted from one generation to the other generation. So study about the transmission of characters from parents to their offsprings is called as genetics. So before entering into the genetics, we will learn some terminology or some terms. First one is the transmission of characters from parents to offspring is called as heredity. But it is not complete. Always there is a little difference due to meiosis. And this little difference among the individuals is called as variation. What leads to variation, or what leads the characters from, or what takes the characters from one generation to the other generation? The factor is called as gene. What is gene? The functional or the expressional part of the chromosome or DNA strand is called as gene. Where the genes are present? The genes are present on chromosomes. What is chromosome? When two sister chromatids are paired, it is called as a chromosome. And in the chromosome, where the genes are located is called as locus. What is a homologous chromosome? A pair of chromosome of same shape, size, and each come from each parent, then it is called as a homologous pair of chromosome. Here in the diagram you can see a pair of homologous chromosome is given. Each is called as a chromosome, and there are two chromosomes which are similar with each other. So this becomes a pair, and as they are similar with each other, they are called as homologous chromosome. Each chromosome contains two sister chromatids, which are jointed with each other at a point which is called as centromere. When the chromosomes are arranged in a chart, it is called as karyotype. Here a karyotype of human being is given, at one side male and the other is of female. Here you can see 23 pairs of chromosomes are there. Up to 22 it is written. These 22 are called as autosomes, and the last pair, that is the 23rd number of pair, is called as sex chromosomes. So chromosomes in our body can be divided into two. One is autosome, another one is sex chromosome. Autosomes are always homologous and 22 pair in number in human beings. And sex chromosome, it is the last pair, and there are two types of sex chromosomes are present. One is X, another one is Y. A female carries 22 autosomes and a pair of X chromosome. Two X chromosomes are there, one from mother, another one from father. This makes the last one pair, and it forms 23 pairs of chromosomes or 46 chromosomes. And female have 22 autosomes and a X and a Y chromosome. X chromosome comes from mother and Y chromosome comes from father. And it makes the last pair, and it forms 23 pairs of chromosomes or 46 chromosomes in male. Here we will learn about some alleles. What is alleles? Alleles are alternative forms of character. When some are discussing that some features are similar to your parents or brothers and sister, what are they comparing about? They are comparing about your characters, physical appearance. That is called as, so any inheritable feature from one generation to the next generation is called as characters. Each characters have two forms. If we will take an example of height, height is a character. Color is a character. And here we are having two alternative forms or two opposite forms. Height can be of tall or dwarf. Color, fair or dark. Like this, when we are having two opposite forms, these opposite or alternative forms of characters are called as alleles. So come to the characters. The characters which are expressed more or in heterozygous condition is called as dominant character. The characters which are seen in less number and expressed in homozygous condition is called as recessive character. Here two words came, that is heterozygous and homozygous. Here we will discuss what is heterozygous or homozygous. Each chromosome contains two sister chromatids. If the two sister chromatids contains same gene for a character, then it is called as homozygous. If a gene or if a chromosome carries two different gene for a same character, then it is called as heterozygous. Here, for example, you can see a chromosome is divided into two chromatids. Here, first one, each chromatid contains two gene for character. Let it be for black. So let it be color. We can consider as color. So B for black. If capital B represents black color, so this is BB, color is black, color is character, and B is the gene. And here as 2B are same and capital in letter, so we will call it as homozygous. And as it is written in capital letter, so we can call it as dominant character. The next example is the last one. The two chromatid contains two small alphabet but same, small b and small b. Small b means it is recessive in nature, and as both are small in letter, so we can call it as homozygous recessive. The middle two, you can see one, first one is carrying capital B and the other chromatid containing small b. Or we can reverse it. In both the condition, each chromatid contains the gene for same character, that is color, but having different gene, that is one dominant gene and another one is recessive gene. Here we can say it as dissimilar pair of gene at the same location. So this is called as a heterozygous condition. When we are writing these genes alphabetically, and this arrangement is called as genotype. Here we can write the first genotype is capital B, capital B. This next two genotype are capital B and small b. Always the dominant is written first, after that recessive one. The last one is small b and small b. So when we are writing these genes only, the arrangement of the gene is called as genotype. When we will write what will be the phenotype or physical appearance, that is capital B, capital M means the person will become black in appearance. So this is called as phenotype. If small b, small b, the recessive one, means the person will fair in color. If capital B, small b is there, what will happen? The dominant character will be expressed. What is the dominant character? That is black. So the person will remain black. And like this, we have to arrange the genes, and according to that, we can know the physical appearance of an organism. Next, we will discuss about Mendel and his experimental materials. Thank you.